at the home of the Mets, City Field. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the New York Mets. Stay tuned for Mets baseball coming up next. David Peterson gets the ball for the Mets in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, in a day and age where we don't see very many complete games, six really good innings in his last start to pick up the win, and I think they'll be happy if he can duplicate that again in this one.
Striding in is Key Brian Hayes. He'll get us started in this one under the lights.
The third baseman, number 13, Key Brian Hayes.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Underway now on a Friday night as the first pitch of our series misses for ball one. Fellas, these Mets, as they enter play here tonight, got to be considered one of, if not the hottest team in baseball right now. Winners of eight of their last 10 ball games.
Yeah, Maddie, this is a nice one. First game of a homestand. You played well on the road. You got a chance to grab a shower and sleep in your own bed last night. I bet you this team comes out on the attack today.
Starting to get a bit chilly here tonight. 57 degrees at game time. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
So here's Michael Chavis now. And he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. And he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two. That was a nasty-looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
So now it's Brian Reynolds. As he'll take a look at his strike on the outside corner, it's 0-1. Will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Popped him up. Escobar has a play, and that retires the side. So a fairly painless top of the first, and now the Mets offense will go to work for the first time. No score. J.T. Brubaker, a righty from the state of Ohio, will do the pitching in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Yeah, Matt, his last start wasn't a particularly good one. Lasted five innings and ended up taking the loss. He's a much better pitcher than that, and I think he's looking to at least, hopefully, pitch into the sixth or seventh inning in this one.
And now, Brandon Nimmo. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the pitch. Dero, Dan, we look at this Pirates ball club as they enter play here tonight. They come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've dropped five of their last eight ball games.
Yeah, Matty, they got beat up on the homestand, losing record in front of the home crowd, never good. But I always used to say sometimes it's good to get on the road, remove yourself, get out to a restaurant, see a different city, shower it off, and try and fight in front of some hostile fans.
Behind 0-2 now. And no swing. It's ball three. Now the 3-2 pitch. Easy fly ball into shallow center field. Reynolds comes on now, and he has it, one down. With a moment here in Flushing Meadows, let's meet the Mets. Dan, who do we keep an eye on?
Well, Matt, I'm going to be paying close attention to Starling Marte. He hit over 320 last year, and that will get any pitcher's attention. They knew it when he was coming up, and they knew it when he was on the on-deck circle. Really impressive hitter.
So Robinson Cano will grab a bat next, as he'll send a ground ball down to third. Throw to first, and Cano's a ground out victim. Two gone.
That is good. Looks at it here. Norway. Martin.
Next to hit is Starling Marte, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Now here it comes.
Right. 1-1.
Here's the 1-1 pitch to third. Lank to it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Mets. Still no score. All set for the start of the inning, and up to the plate next is Andrew Vaughn. Back up the middle, and the Pirates have their first base hit. With that, the Buccos have their leadoff man aboard to kick off the inning.
3-1 fastball, middle cut, and he didn't miss it. That's the fight throughout the course of the game. To get yourself into count, leverage, and capitalize.
Here's the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Vaughn aboard here at first with nobody out. High in the air and deep to left center field. Back goes Rosario at the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Here's the defensive alignment for the New York Metropolitans. And let's focus on Robinson Cano, one of the softest hands in all our sport. Probably turns one of the best double plays in the game, captain of the defense.
At the plate, Poi-Jun Park fouled away. First swings for him in this one, with a runner still at first and one gone. And no one will track it down. The 2-2 one more time. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Another look at the throwdown that results in a third out on the bases. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. J.D. Davis the next at bat. Set to lead off the home half of the second. First delivery to him. Hot shot to third and handled for the first out.
That is good.
Time for a look at the Buccos on D. And let's focus our attention on catcher Travis d'Arnaud. He's going to have to step up today and have a big game for these guys. Not known necessarily for his defensive acumen, more of a big pop guy on the offensive side. He has got to control this game.
So here's Pete Alonso as he swings and grounds it toward the hole. And a good effort on the dive that time, but this will get by him for a base hit.
Nothing fires me up more than watching an offensive player stay inside a baseball and drive it the other way.
Here's Eduardo Escobar batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. but facing right-handed pitching so far this season, Escobar is a batting line residing in the 230s.
He'd be the first to tell you he's not happy with his batting average this season, but he can beat you in a variety of different ways, and he has to because he would.
And the throw to first is there. The inning is over. The love of the game runs deep with these folks. Two complete. Still scoreless here on the show. Now into the box, Ryan McBroom, 7-8-9, bottom of the order set to go here in the third.
McBroom.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
High bouncer toward the hole. Davis has got it. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. And with that, we give you a look at what's happening in the NL East race. Set to get his evening at the plate started. Kevin Newman trying to get it going at the plate. It's been tough sledding for him so far this year. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Not even close on that swing. No balls and a strike. Third inning, no score to this point. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on. And when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Stepping in now, JT Brubaker. As with two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1. Shallow center field, and that'll get down for a base hit.
Boy, Dewar, you're talking about frustrating as a pitcher. You have the pitcher up with two outs, and he extends the inning there with a base hit.
Yeah, it's funny. I've hit eighth in my career, and the grind was to try and get the pitcher up so you could base that out and flip the lineup over. This guy took it into his own hands and did just that. By getting a knock, now we could have some issues here.
Key Brian Hayes digging in now. First pitch to him is off the plate for a ball. 1-0. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. The 1-0 home. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Marte on the move. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Pirates lead one. Home half of the third coming up. No score. So now to the plate, Eddie Rosario is ready for his first at bat of this early season contest. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Two and two. They've locked horns. Here's the next offering. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And there's out number one.
Batting it, the catcher. Jump off. Nito.
Next, it'll be Tomas Nito. And he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. And now the first pitch. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number two.
Batting ninth, the pitcher, David Peterson.
Next to stand in is David Peterson. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at bat. It's 1-0. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Back goes Chavis. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Mets go down 1-2-3. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. All set for the start of the fourth, and Michael Chavis will step in at the plate.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
No balls and a strike to count. This is hit high and deep out to left. Looking up is Rosario. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to left. Second home run early in the year. And the Pirates are staked to a 1-0 lead.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
Standing in now, Brian Reynolds. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. Comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ball game. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. This is on the ground over to first. He's got it, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. Both guys pretty close, top speeds of 95 and 94. Andrew Vaughn the next to bat. One run in and one gone so far in this inning. To first, scooped up, and he'll step on first himself for the out.
Now back, the catcher, Rabbit Darno.
Base is empty, two away, and up next, the catcher, Travis Darno.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And a check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three, and the inning is over. But the Pirates are on the board first thanks to this home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 1-0 Pittsburgh. So here's Brandon Nimmo. It was a flyout for him to start the home first.
So right here's that sinker to end up, but that was a nice job of laying off.
Now the 2-1. Liner towards second, but this will be taken in at second base. Good positioning for the first down.
The batter number 24, second baseman, Robinson.
So one out and nobody aboard, and set to stand in the fine second baseman Robinson Cano. Cano waits on the first pitch. Curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on first for the out, 3 unassisted.
The center fielder, number 6, Garland.
Here's Starling Marte. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Here's the first pitch. Now a swing and a weak little line drive over to first. And no problem over there at first as he flags this one down to end the inning. So nothing happening this time around. On to the top of inning number 5 we go. Bucks out in front, 1-0. All ready to go in the top of the 5th. And set to go is the second baseman, Hoi-Joon Park. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. Shin high. That's taken for a ball. Chopper to short. He's got it. And the 5th inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting, the first baseman, Ryan McBroom.
Next, it'll be Ryan McBroom. He bounced out last time up. First pitch of the AB on its way. Swung on and missed, so it's 2 up, 2 down to start the 5th.
The great equalizer, the changeup. That was a really good job of getting him to offer that one out of the zone, and it was all set up by the fact that he got ahead of the count and forced the hitter to have to protect. That's the name of the game.
So now to the plate, Kevin Newman. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. He's 0 for 1 thus far. That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
In the dirt, but swung on and missed. Up with it, Nito. And the throw to first ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Pirates, but they lead it 1-0. Welcome back to Flushing, Queens. Before we get back to baseball, let's check in with Heidi.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with the Mets manager to discuss his thoughts on his club's offense so far. And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, J.D. Davis. He'll lead things off as we begin the home 5th. First pitch on its way. As he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning. So only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, man, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
Into the box, Pete Alonso, who collected a base hit his first time up. In there for strike one, 0-1.
Great job by the pitcher right there, changing eye levels. We all know he's a sinker ball pitcher, but if he could throw some four seamers,
this is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Eduardo Escobar standing in as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. Eduardo Escobar.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. To second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. One pitch, two outs. The pitcher's best friend in the inning. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Now to the plate, JT Brubaker. Opportunity to bat for himself with his guys up a run here in the sixth.
It's amazing how guys can lose focus sometimes when the weaker hitters come up, especially the pitchers. You got to stay on the attack and minimize pitches and get these guys out in a hurry.
That misses as well. It's ball four, and it's a four-pitch walk to the pitcher leading off the inning. Wow.
Well, that is definitely not the way to start an inning. One thing to give up a walk, but to do it on four pitches is pretty alarming. He looks a little thrown off right now.
Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Key Brian Hayes. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Swing and a liner. So this is pulled in by the shortstop.
The right fielder, number 31, Michael Chavis.
Michael Chavis will stride in again, and you can bet he'd love to do again what he did back in the fourth. A solo home run here that's been the only long ball of the game so far. First pitch of the AB on its way. And there's a strike right down the heart of the plate. 0-1.
You know, a lot of guys don't like to swing at the first pitch. That might be the case with this one right here. Took a wheel.
Even at 2-2.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And, hey, a strikeout always works, too.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring up Brian Reynolds. As a look, now the pitch.
No, that's the ball.
Here it comes, 1-0. Skied into straightaway right. Waiting on it is Nimmo. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. One left for Pittsburgh, but they're up 1-0. stepping in. Eddie Rosario. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, let's see if he can work a walk, maybe a non-ground ball with eyes, something. Catch a gap to get this offense going.
Same pitch that time, the sinker, but it looked like he made a good adjustment with it.
Yeah, Matt, that's a great point. Released it from out front much better that time. I just think he wasn't real happy with the first one he threw, so he wanted to get the feel back for it.
And there's one down now.
The catcher, number three, Jeter.
So the next to bat will be Tomas Nido. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
It really keeps his pitch count down.
Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And a base hit as that's in the left, and they've got themselves a base runner.
Dan, how hard is it to massage your way through such a deep lineup? I mean, even the 8-9 hole hitters are solid big league players.
You know, Mark, these days you're not seeing a lot of defensive specialists in the infield or outfield. If you're in that starting lineup these days, there's a pretty good job you can swing the bat.
Into the box, David Peterson. Now a bunt attempt here, but they'll just get the one out here as the runner will get back safely at first.
The right fielder, number 9.
And here's the former first-round draft choice, Brandon Nimmo. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. From the belt, kicks and deals. Here's a ball well struck for the right field corner. And that'll get over the wall, so the runner will have to hold up at third.
Off the bat, it looked like that might bring their first run of the game across. But those hopes ended quickly when it hopped over the wall. Everyone gets two bases on a ground rule double, so the runner from first is forced to stay at third, and the next guy is going to have to be the one to put them on the board.
Here comes the second baseman, Robinson Cano. Ball one. 0-for-2 for him to this point.
He can hurt you in a heartbeat. I don't think anything's going to leak out over the heart of the plate.
And there's ball four as this one gets away a bit.
Yeah, and if you can make it all the way to the sixth inning before you give up a walk, you're doing something right. He's been very efficient so far, so we'll see if he can get back on track here.
Digging in next will be Starling Marte, trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
Ball.
Hey, this pitcher's going to have to step off the mound right here and refocus. Take a deep breath, something. Can't keep falling behind and creating traffic. It puts everybody on edge, not only himself, his defense, and especially his manager.
Now a ball ripped into deep center field. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. Mets leave them loaded. They trail this one 1-0. Digging in will be Andrew Vaughn. And guys, seventh inning already. Hey, I'm not complaining, but this one's been flying by.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you get when both starting pitchers have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
Throwing a good fastball located and mixing in that nasty changeup with good arm action.
And he rings up another one. Make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game.
pulled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down. And that appeared to be the case. Those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Hit on the ground out to short. Throw on to first, two gone.
Now back, second baseman, Hoi-Joon Park.
And now here is Hoi-Joon Park, grounded out in his last at bat. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Cano fields it cleanly. They'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. So they breeze through this half of the inning. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. Pirates lead it 1-0. Last half of the seventh here, and next the dangerous power threat, J.D. Davis. Chopped toward the second baseman. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out.
Now back, the first baseman.
Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning.
Up at number 10, shortstop, Eduardo Escobar.
Next to dig in, Eduardo Escobar. He was a double play
so far in this one.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Next to hit, Eddie Rosario. And we'll see if they can make him pay for the two-out walk, always considered a big no-no, of course. Escobar leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. In there, a base hit. The hold at second, and there are two aboard now.
Count leverage right there, sitting dead red fastball, and he didn't miss it. Nice swing right there, driving it into the outfield for a knock.
Now time is called here as we'll get a trip to the mound. Into the box now, Tomas Nido.
He'll take a look at his...
Weak grounder down the first baseline. Scooped up, and the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. No runs, a hit, two left. Eighth inning coming up. Pittsburgh leads this one, 1-0. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Seth Lugo will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. James McCann is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Ready to begin the eighth, and here comes the first baseman, Ryan McBroom.
Ryan McBroom.
Bobby Bradley is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth.
Number 44, Bobby Bradley.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. And a ball 1-0. And he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. Here now the 2-2. On a good curveball, gets him swinging for out number one. Find the line there for the Mets starting pitcher, and he was really in command on the mound throughout the evening.
Hey, only allowed 3 hits in this one, kept the hitters off balance, and was a lot of fun to watch.
In now, Kevin Newman. As he'll cut on and miss it, a good slider at the knees for strike one. No
hits. Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Rafael Ortega will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 66, Rafael Ortega.
First offering on its way, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. You see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. Three-two pitch. Breezes him. Strikeout looking. Very tight ball game so far. 1-0 the score as we take a look at our starter comparison, and both guys have given excellent performances to this point. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Key Brian Hayes. We could really use a knock here. 0-for-3 in the game so far. He comes set. Here's the 0-0 pitch.
Ball.
Newman, the runner at first, with two gone. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Rosario will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Pirates leave one. They lead it 1-0. Bobby Bradley stays in the ballgame after pinch hitting as he'll take over at first base.
Now playing first base, number 44.
Richard Rodriguez is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 48, Richard Rodriguez.
So here is James McCann. Getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Now the pitch. Back kept the middle and in for a base hit. So with that, the Mets have a runner aboard to get the inning underway.
The leadoff hitter finds his way on base. Should be interesting to see the cat and mouse with the manager. Does he use the bunt right here? Do we put a little hit and run on? Do we go old school, new school, and just let him swing away? Should be interesting.
Stepping in now, Brandon Nimmo, as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. Lifetime in this matchup, just a 3-for-13 batting line. A foul ball. A runner at first with no outs here. Fouled away. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And a slider bounces, and that gets away. And not what they were hoping for, as that moves the possible tying run into scoring position.
Well, the intent there with that two-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with, but there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up free bases.
Here's a little chopper up the middle. Newman's got it, and that's the first down.
Second baseman, Robinson Cano.
So stepping in is Robinson Cano. Potential tying run for him at third base. As though they're going to set up the double play. There's the free pass signal, so there'll be runners at the corners with one gone.
The center fielder, number six, Garland.
Tommy Pham will be summoned now to be the pinch runner. Next up is Starling Marte. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Stretch, here's the pitch. Swing and a fly ball. And this should at least get home the tying run. Catch is made. Here comes the tying run from third. He's in there at the plate. And we are tied here in the eighth.
That was a really good at bat right there. You're trying to tie this thing up any way that you can. He hits the sack fly to the outfield, and the tying run comes in to score.
Here's the first pitch to him. J.D. Davis is in with two away as he takes a ball, 1-0.
A great case of a manager sticking up for his pitcher right there and giving that umpire an earful. He didn't get that pitch called the way he wanted it to, but the manager's planting a seed in that umpire's mind to try to expand the strike zone so some of those borderline pitches start to go his pitcher's way.
His prior history in this matchup, he's 1-for-5. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. Runners on the move for second. Pitch inside, the throw, and he is out at second. Caught stealing to end the inning. But the tying run comes across to score here, as this one looks like it'll go to the wire. We've played eight full, all tied at 1-1. Francisco Lindor will come on defensively now as he takes over at second.
Now playing second base, Number 12, Francisco Lindor.
Now it'll be Michael Chavis. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
First pitch of the AB on its way. Swing and a ground ball to third. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Not a lot you can do with that pitch. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
Now to the plate, here is Ryan Reynolds. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Pitch on the way. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Well off the plate inside.
You can certainly tell at-bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
The left fielder, number 25.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Andrew Vaughn. It's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. Here's the first pitch.
No.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Runner goes for second. Got him swinging. The throw. Skips in and he's safe. Close play, but he's in there.
They ran the risk of a strike him out, throw him out play there, but that was a good job of getting in there successfully. On 3-2, there's a decent chance the hitter puts the ball in place, so it can be a good time to be aggressive just like that.
Carlos Carrasco has been summoned here and will try to keep this one tied heading to the bottom of the ninth. Travis d'Arnone will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away. Oneil Cruz will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Here's the first pitch. It's his job to get something into the outfield and give that go-ahead run a chance to score from second. Comes set, the 0-1.
Ball. The frame 11, 1-1.
Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
Two balls, two strikes.
Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Still 2-2. This is pulled into right. Nimmo gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. One left for Pittsburgh. Score remains tied 1-1. Yusmer Petit enters to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra innings. Michael Perez is into the ballgame here as he takes over behind the plate.
Now catching number five.
Bottom of the inning now, and stepping in the long ball threat, J.D. Davis.
Third baseman, J.D.
Now here's the first offering. Liner towards second. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field.
Leadoff base hit to start the bottom of the ninth inning right here. Everybody in the dugout on their feet, top stepping it. We're going to see if he works a bunt, hit and run. I don't know. Maybe he's swinging for the gap, and he gets to be the hero himself.
Standing in now, Pete Alonso. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Vaughn will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
The batter number 10, shortstop, Eduardo.
Now at the plate, Eduardo Escobar. He can make these fans go nuts and secure the win if he can place a ball deep enough into the gap. Here's the first pitch as he'll take a look at ball one.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood in a broken bat.
Oh, on the ground is short. Could this be two? The second for one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first.
That was kind of a high degree of difficulty play that time. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and he couldn't get a lot on it, but they did get the out.
To the plate now, Eddie Rosario, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. In previous matchups with Yusmeiro Petit, small sample, a perfect one for one. The 0-1. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Whoa, he was swinging out of his shoes on that changeup. Must have looked real good coming in, but a different story once it got near the plate.
Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there.
So the intent of that 0-2 cutter right there isn't necessarily to get a swinging strike. If you get it, well, hey, that's great. But if you get it inside enough and he does make contact, he probably can't do anything with it anyway.
Here's the 1-2. Bottom dropped out on him, and that's a strikeout. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means we'll have to go a little longer tonight to find a winner. 10th inning coming up, all tied at 1-1. So now here is Hoi-Joon Park. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Now a ball line hard toward deep right field. Nimmo is there and he makes the catch for the out.
I know they say sometimes that these things even out, but that was a bullet line drive that gets caught. He would have represented the go-ahead run.
At the plate, Bobby Bradley, as he swings and misses at a first pitch.
Last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
On the ground to the right side. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And he'll make it to first easily on what will almost certainly be ruled an infield single.
The good one, Kevin Newman.
Into the box, Kevin Newman. He swings and grounds it to short. Fielded cleanly. There's one on to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. Cannon Smith. We'll get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 24, Cannon Smith.
Here's the first pitch. As he'll take a look at the pitch too low, it's ball one. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. And he's behind one and two. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. High in the air out to center field. Marte finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Pirates leave one. Still tied, one apiece. Chris Stratton comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning.
Number 46, Chris Stratton.
Luis Guillorme is going to come in and pinch hit here as he's the potential winning run here in the bottom half of inning number 10. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. As he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. And he's looking to get it going. Off to a bit of a slow start this year. Now the 1-0.
Drive.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
I think he kind of trained a hitter's eyes in that at bat. What I mean is you'll find the first three pitches are all down around the knee. So as a hitter, he's probably looking down there again, and that's the perfect time to raise his sights and make a good pitch up.
In now, James McCann. Now McCann with a swing and a deep drive to left. And that ball is gone. Santa Maria, game over. So a solo shot here to left center field. And with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get to extra innings, you're looking to piece together a rally or scratch any runs you can across the plate. But he says, hey, to heck with that. I'm going to do it with one swing of the bat. So a walk-off home run ends this thing in extras. That was fun.
Close one tonight, 2-1, the final score. New York secured their 10th victory of the season. Carlos Carrasco gets the win in relief, his second of the year. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the Victoria.